We are discussing attribute and domain. Attributes are the descriptive properties of each and every entity in an entity set. So, using this attribute, we usually hold multiple values against one entity. In the previous video, we have discussed what is entity and entity set. Please watch that one. This video is the continuation of the previous one. So, in the previous video, we have given this particular example that this is one entity set for student. So, that is a student entity. This is one student entity. This is another student entity. So, they are alike. So, it is forming one student entity set. So, this student entity is having this particular 4 against the attribute roll number Humayun Kobir, this particular attribute against the student name, and this 21 against the attribute age. So, here we are having 3 attributes: role, name and age. So, these 3 are the attributes. So, attributes are descriptive properties possessed by each member of an entity set. Okay. Now, how many different types of attributes are there? Attributes mainly can be categorized into 5 different categories. The first category is the simple attribute. What is a simple attribute? In our year diagram, which will be coming next in the next videos, we shall represent attribute within one ellipse. So, that notation we have used here. But all the details about different other symbols used in the year diagram, we have discussed that one in the later video. So, here you see this EMP ID is a simple attribute, example of one simple attribute. Why? Because this EMP ID cannot be divided further. So, that is a simple attribute. If you are not getting, please come to the composite attribute. Now, what is a composite attribute? Name is a composite attribute, and you see this name can be divided into sub attributes like your first name, middle name and the last name. So, these are also attributes, and after splitting this name, I am getting these attributes. So, that is why it is composite, but here this attribute is not getting splitted. So, that is why it is called simple attribute. If you think that you will be keeping only name as I did here, you will be keeping only name, you shall not split it to first name, middle name, last name, then name can also be one simple attribute. So, it depends only upon the implementation. Now, we are going to discuss what is a single valued attribute. Single valued attribute can be given in one example as date of birth. A person cannot have more than one date of birth. So, that is why this DOB is one single valued attribute, because that attribute can contain only one value. On the other hand, if you go for the multi valued attribute, then this employee email ID can be a good example of multi valued attribute. And in year diagram, we will be representing it using double ellipse. So, email ID, because one person can have multiple email ID, and one corporate email ID, at least one personal email ID. So, a person can have multiple email IDs. So, that is why this email ID will be a good example of this multi-valued attribute. Now, the last one is the derived attribute. And this derived attribute will be denoted by dotted ellipse in year diagram. So, age is a good example of your derived attribute, because if I know the date of birth, then subtracting it from the system's current date, I can calculate this age. So, there is no need to pass value from the external source. Using some internal calculation, using some business logic, I can find out this particular value of this attribute. So, age is a good example of derived attribute. For the other examples, you can go for employment length. So, that means for how many days one employee is working in an organization. So, that can easily be done by subtracting system date minus date of joining. So, employment length is also a good example of this derived attribute represented by dotted ellipse in year diagram. So, you see, these are the attribute types, and these are the examples and the respective representation techniques in the year diagram. We will be having a separate video in the year diagram. There we will be going for all other symbols, and obviously these symbols will be also discussed there again. The last topic is the domain. What is a domain? For each attribute, there is a set of permitted values called domain or value set of that attribute. So, domain is nothing but a set of values or pool of values from where we can pick up one value to instantiate one attribute. So it is a pool of values from where we can pick up one value to instantiate one attribute. So instantiation one attribute means you are just initializing that one, and for holding that particular attribute value, obviously during implementation it will occupy some memory space in the computer's memory. So that is our domain. As an example, we can consider that the domain of this roll number is of the type integer, domain of this name is of the type string, domain of this age of the type real if you allow the fractional part, otherwise it is integer. So similarly, it is string, and this is not a string, because you might be biased that domain means the data type, not like that. Say, let us suppose this particular library can have books from the subjects physics, chemistry, mathematics, biology and computer. Say 5 different subjects are there: physics, chemistry, mathematics, biology and computer. So 5 subjects are there. So this particular column, this particular attribute, that is the subject name, can get instantiated, can get initialized from any one of the values from the set of 5 values: physics, chemistry, mathematics, biology and computer science. So these 5 values, out of these 5 values, one value will be coming to instantiate this attribute, that is a book subject. So that is a domain. So we have discussed what is attribute, we have discussed what is a domain with the proper examples, and also different categories of attributes discussed in this particular session. Thanks for watching this video.